November 10th, 2012. A group of young college students join for a fun day at the pool, unaware of the danger that awaits.
I don't think he can swim!
Oh no!
Oh no, let's help him!
What the students don't know is the water itself is not the only hazard to this unsuspecting victim. Giardia Lamblia can survive for weeks to months in water in its cyst stage and is highly resistant to water treatment methods such as chlorination and ozonolysis. The cyst remains inactive until ingested by a host. The parasite enters our unfortunate host orally and then travels to his small intestine. The cyst emerges from its dormant phase at a process known as exudation into its active stage, called the trophozoite. The trophozoites are the growing stage of sporozoan parasites that colonize the gut and feed on the host's mucus secretions. The trophozoites then undergo longitudinal binary fission, a form of asexual reproduction, after which the Giardia travels down to the host's small intestine and into the colon. In the colon, the trophozoites undergo encystation and produce the now infectious cyst that is excreted in the feces. This student is suffering from nausea, one of the many manifestations of a Giardia lamblia infection. The vomiting induced by this type of protozoa has been previously described as violent and unforgiving. The infection causes the host to experience flatulence, producing a strong, pungent smell.
Dude! Seriously?
Dude, you remember when I was at pool, like, 2 weeks ago?
Yeah,
wow. Dude, I've been dropping mad loads, dude. Like, crazy.
Dude, great.
Women's? Alright.
The symptom is caused by the Giardia lamblia coating the host mucous membrane cells, which inhibits nutrition absorption, resulting in explosive diarrhea. Blood and mucus may be present in the feces of an infected host. Tests for the diagnosis of giardiasis include antigen testing, in which a small sample of stool is examined for giardial proteins. It could also be diagnosed by a fecal examination under a microscope.
Is there a Mike Sharps? A Mike Sharps.
Right here.
Hello. How are you doing today?
Fantastic.
Okay, well, your results came back from your fecal examination, and it looks as if you have a severe case of giardiasis.
Giardiasis?
Yeah, giardiasis. It's also known as beaver fever.
Beaver fever?
Beaver fever.
Am I gonna die?
No, you're not gonna die. You might be in discomfort for a while, but I'm gonna have you a prescription of Flagyl. And all you're going to do is you're going to be on that for 7 to 10 days, and I need you to drink lots of water, lots of fluids in your system. Stay out of the water, no more dirty water. That's how you can get it. It's a protozoan. And just take the prescription, and you should be okay in a while. You'll have a lot of discomfort in the meantime, but overall, you'll be fine.
Good news, Doc.
No problem.
Thank you.
Have a great day. So, ladies and gentlemen, please be careful not to end up like Mike Sharps. Prevention is possible. Be aware of the condition of the water you come in contact with. Purify all drinking water or filter it. Please be aware of the condition of the large bodies of water you come in contact with. Keep your mouth closed in pools, lakes, rivers, etc. Avoid eating contaminated food. Wash all produce with uncontaminated water before consumption. Always be careful to stay away from unsanitary conditions. Thoroughly clean areas where sick pets or people may have been. Be aware of possible contact with fecal matter. Be sure to frequently wash your hands with soap and water. And most important of all, never forget to practice good hygiene at all times. Good luck, guys.